on, this is Extreme, and I'm doing a little voiceover of some recorded material that I have in regards to the new hero unit, the Wasp. Right, I am allowed to tell you guys a couple of things about the Wasp, but I need to keep it short, so I'm just going to do the requested numbers, and I'll put the Combat Hero in another video. So first we'll take a look at the Wasp, and I have been analyzing this thing for you guys. Alright then, first things first, in the top corner you see Uranium. You only need to pay it once in the game for activating the Wasp, then you can train the Wasp. Next game you need to pay to Uranium again to activate it again. So you need to repay the Uranium over and over again. That is if you want to use the Wasp. Alright then, as you can see there are some statistics going on the right. You can see the health, the speed, the resource cost, the armor, the viewage, the build time, and of course the CP. It doesn't differ that much from a Dragonfly, but let's just say it's roughly almost as twice as strong as a Dragonfly, and it costs roughly as twice as much. Then we got some activities, a active ability and a passive ability, and I'm going to talk about them shortly and how to use them best against our enemies. All other stuff you see on the screen is of no use talking about. It can be changed, I don't know. I don't know the details about them, so just pay no attention to that. Alrighty then. Let's move on to the next part. Alright then, here's the active ability. You can activate this in the game. It will be an acid thrown on the ground. It will be active for a couple of seconds. You will see a little indication on enemy units, and the effect will be roughly 80% more damage. Keep in mind this is for all weapons, and afterwards the armor will be subtracted, is what I suspect, but might be the other way around. It doesn't matter, it was supposed to be a supportive unit for the Dragonflies, which is actually going to be shown in the video. However, I have devised a different strategy with these guys already, of which you will be seeing more in the future. Something important to notice is that the ability recharge time, it takes a considerable amount of time. Well, you know what word I meant. I'm struggling with difficult English words. Oh well. You can see the damage it does. It's not much, but if you have a lot of other units, they will roughly be doing twice the amount of damage. Roughly. So I simply thought of, well, we already have a couple of units doing a lot of damage. Let's add them again to the army, like the Jaguar and the Grenadier. Believe it or not, the Grenadier is going to be very useful. Right, the duration is relatively short, so whatever you attack with the acid burst, you need to attack it right away or else this activity is lost. That's the first part. This is active ability. Now to the passive one. Right, and the passive ability would be the Mist Disguise. When the a wasp or anything flying around the wasp is being attacked by anything, then a cloud is created so that the wasp or anything around in the cloud will take less damage. How much less damage? 63% accuracy will be removed. That means that only 37% of the damage will remain, and that's after all the other combat mechanics. So I guess, I'm not sure, but it might be less for those weapons that have less accuracy anyway. So 63 is actually a lot if you think about it. If something with 63% accuracy is shooting at you. Okay? It's still only 8 seconds, so shoot the wasp, then shoot something else that's outside the cloud, and then shoot the wasp again after 8 seconds and you win easily. That's all there is to it, okay? That's the strategy I'm going to dismiss. This guy's. Right, on to the next part. Of course, there's still some text added to the wasp, and I guess I'll just show it to you guys now. You can pause the video, obviously, on all the texts and read it for yourself and make your own conclusion. And here's the most effective against infantry, apparently, which is not the case in my opinion. But hey, here's the text. And that big arrow is in the way. Oh well. Well, there you have it. Enjoy reading. And yes, yes, there is actually a special feature that may get your attention. You can land the wasp to get control points and containers. Okay, so there's one more thing, the Sting Capsule Missiles. This little hero actually has a weapon of its own. It's not just a spot unit, but actually it can shoot little missiles. And that would actually be about it. That's it. It has some missiles, but not really that spectacular. Looks cool, but it's actually relatively weak in comparison to the Convert Hero. Well then, there you have it. All the details of the Wasp until now. By the way, keep in mind that firing range of 6.1 is actually a very unique thing that I have seen. Normally you have a round number or half range. Okay, there you have it. Let's go to the battle. Well, excuse me for actually muting the sound of the gameplay. I had the music in the background running, not realizing that it might be actually annoying to the rest. I also had commentary during the recording, but I guess I'll simply record afterwards. Maybe I should have recorded this without adding the original music or whatever. Anyway, right, I still remember my basic strategies. My plan was to produce Rifleman, but Coyote as well. I already played with the Convert Hero prior to this one, but I decided to upload the Resistance Hero first for you guys. So I did notice that gathering crates actually takes time now. You need to stand close to the crate, which is actually a little bit fairer in regards to that thing you call a skill cover crate collection. Yes, it's a thing now. So Resistance is going to revert back to original strategy of having a squad of two riflemen, which can deal with one assault, or a Coyote. So I'm building Coyote again. I often use Coyote as support, even especially on the biggest maps. But the squad of Riflemen, as you can see, has the idea of actually taking crates. So actually this is a little bit something different than the hero you were expecting right away. Because this is something I wanted to tell you guys. Yes, the crate collection. So I'll skip a little bit forward to my next part of this match. Alrighty then, as you can see the map is explored a little bit more. Now I've taking a lot of crates because hey, I am fighting against Fat Scotch, and yeah, as you can see, he is already building that hero building for his hero. I'm going to gather all units in my base now and retreating all units. And as you can see, I've built a prototype factory. I'm going to get myself a prototype of the Wasp and gathering resources, placing the rally points separately. I think they are going to fix the rally points a bit. As you can see, I'm just taking my time at the time being because it's 4 minutes, it's rank 16 again, and there it is, my first dragonfly. I'm going to build a squad of dragonflies with the wasp as intended in the first place for the heroes. But I don't know if I mentioned before, but the wasp can reduce the armor or actually increases the damage of all units firing at whatever is going to eat the glob of a poisonous acid. Anyway, that means that even Rifleman, Coyote, or whatever unit you use, they will get 80% more damage. Now, if the armor is reduced from this or not, I do not know that yet. We'll find out. But hey, fast firing weapons will be more of use to the Resistance in the future. Keep that in mind. So I'm going to place more barracks. Because there's one more thing I can tell you. I'm going grenadiers in this one as well. And then porcupines again. So porcupines fast firing. Grenadiers, however, will be doing more damage as well. They are relatively fast firing. But the enemy hero, the Sabrerers, has tier 2 armor, and I'm going to use that advantage, that knowledge, to my advantage. I'm going to get grenadiers, going to get myself porcupines, dragonflies, and the wasp, and then my team is complete and I'll be attacking Fat Squatch. Alright, then we skip forward again in the match, and as you can see, I'm about to launch my first attack. I'm going to use the wasp to reduce the armor of buildings. Is this possible or not? Let's see, let's observe. It's going to use a special ability like this. There we go. Yes, it does effect. As you can see, it does a symbol in the screen. And as long as that symbol is there, the building would be taking more damage. Although those dragonflies, I don't know if it had really effect. I got 5 fighting that building right now. And the ability is recharging. It's an orange hexagon around it. And it's recharged. As you can see, it lights up again and I can use it again. I know there's him building a vertex, and I'm going to try to destroy his avia factory. Then I suddenly had a bad idea. Let's destroy his airfield instead, because then his vertex is paused. And I got more time, because he needs to rebuild his airfield. The airfield is weaker. Yeah. I don't know if it was wise enough of me doing this, but guess what? Fat Squatch is actually a little bit faster these days. So he's launching his vertex, and he's going to attack. Believe it or not, my wasp. So the cloud is activated, as you can see, and it will be taking less damage. Sure, I can move around with the wasp, but it's not going to help me much. I'm just taking the damage. And the special, actually, the passive ability will be seen by the bluish one-sided hexagon. It should be able to activate now. Yes, there it is. So it's going to be used again. The blue bar depletes and it's gone. That actually felt really short for 8 seconds, to be honest. Okay, the wasp is dead now, and we are going to enjoy destroying the rest of Fat Squatch bases. What we thought, that factory is going down. I'm just going to upgrade my 8 squad. We have now on to the next part of this battle. Oh, or are we going to eat and see how I'm going to die? I believe I retreated some of these dragonflies, to be honest. Yeah, there we go. Okay, on to the next part of the battle. Right then, as you can see, more time has passed and I'm just going to attack Fat Squatch because, well, I grow tired of waiting. I must feast on souls! Alright, then there we go. So I gathered all my units, to be honest, even the dragonflies are underway. And there you have it, the sombreros of the confet. He lands between my grenadiers, then they shoot the sombreros. And believe it or not, this lag was real in the game, so he wanted to activate his shield but died prior. So there you have it, mass grenadiers all shooting at the same unit at the same time. Just indicates he's not really that durable, to be honest. It's different with a Viking if you have that much army. A Viking actually lives longer. So I'm using he's shooting at my wasp. The cloud is activated, and I am going to use the acid on that Zeus. He's actually dying faster. Especially do porcupines have proven to be very effective too against Zeus. Now even more so. Anyway, that's a little secret. So there we go, I'm just attacking Fat Squatch. I'm going to kill him. Enjoy. Now he's going to die. So I'm just shooting at his buildings and kinda got fed up. Well, I'm just using all the rapid fire units. Grenadiers for his hero. Dragonflies that were built during the first attack and decide to use all my units on his H-Squad. The grenades do a lot of damage now and everything is shooting at it. Suddenly a lot of damage, wow, look at that. That's the effect of the wasp added to your army. Use it on certain key buildings and they are dead. And that was a tier 3 H-Squad, and against an army like this, normally you would be doing a lot of waiting. Not a lot of damage. Yes. So there we go. Okay, there was a bit of that now. Actually, I should have retreated my area a bit. Somebody focus on his AA towers and stuff. But there you have it, I'm just going to kill him. Not more thread. Okay, no more heroes, so I guess on to the next part. Which obviously would be victory is mine. Anyway, this is how the wasp is being used as effective as possible. I hope you all liked this little video. Yeah, I'm sorry I had to cut it as short as possible. But this is a strategy devised by me for the wasp. And there you have it, Vesquash is defeated. And well, I guess on to the end screen. Anyway, keep in mind, all units' damage is almost doubled, so and seeing the timing of how long the effect takes place and actually the firing speed of certain units, simply use them. Alrighty then, just keep in mind, some units are really effective now. Right, then we got the four corners, obviously, and we got the down left corner with Tracy, down right corner, Fast Squatch, top right corner would be Major Pain, and top left corner would be me. Fat Squatch has a video about the heroes. I don't know if Tracy has one, but if I spot one, I'll put it in there. And the rest would be mandatory. There you have it. I'll guess top left corner will be me pointing out the Confet video, which should only be uploaded after this one. There you have it. Thank you all for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye bye!